Look at the next question, dear students. Summation r is equal to 1 to n, r into r factorial is. See, we have summation r is equal to 1 to n, r into r factorial. See, we'll write this r as r plus 1 minus 1. See, r into r factorial we have. This r, I'll write it as r plus 1 minus 1 into r factorial. Is that correct? So, now let me take this inside, and before that, let me split the brackets. So, you'll get r plus 1 into r factorial minus r factorial. What is r plus 1 into r factorial? R plus 1 into r factorial is nothing but equal to r plus 1 factorial minus r factorial. Is that correct? So now this, we have just considered the term which is inside. Now the question is, let me call this as S. S is equal to summation r is equal to 1 to n r plus 1 factorial minus r factorial. Let us start using the values. When r is equal to 1, you will get 1 plus 1, 2 factorial minus 1 factorial. Is that correct? That is the first bracket. Plus, next is, we will substitute r is equal to 2. If we substitute r is equal to 2, we will get 2 plus 1, 3 factorial minus 2 factorial. Is that correct? Plus, when we substitute r is equal to 3, we will get 4 factorial minus 3 factorial. You can see here, 4 factorial minus 3 factorial plus 5 factorial minus 4 factorial. Like that it continues. Last but one will be, this is n minus 1 plus 1, that is n factorial minus n minus 1 factorial plus n plus 1 factorial minus n factorial. Right? So now, if you see all these, n factorial cancels, n minus 1 factorial cancels with n minus 1 factorial here, 4 factorial cancels with 4 factorial here, 5 factorial cancels with a term 5 factorial here, 3 factorial, 2 factorial cancels. So, what is left out? The only thing which is left out is minus 1 factorial and n plus 1 factorial. Do you agree with me? So, that is n plus 1 factorial minus 1 factorial. That is n plus 1 factorial minus 1. So, n plus 1 factorial minus 1 means option C is correct. Understood this, dear students? So, please make a note of this.